Assalamualaikum and greetings to all. I'm Nur Suhaira Jamil from Polytechnic Sultan Idris Shah, and today I will be presenting a conceptual paper titled Financial Ratios and Their Importance to Investors, a Review. This paper was co-written by Siti Nasuhah Mohbin and Nur Hidayati Muhammad Kusni, two of my friends.
Two experts believe Malaysia's stock market performance is unlikely to improve significantly because of systemic problems. Jeffrey Williams of the Malaysia University of Science and Technology said the stock market has been on a downward trend for almost a decade. Liu Chi-Yung of the Center for Market Education said the stock market's poor performance would continue due to a combination of the ringgit's depreciation, scandals in corporate governance, and weak legal enforcement in the capital markets. Williams said investors would continue to look elsewhere as other regional markets with larger customer bases have greater potential for strong growth. He also pointed out that even with good economic performance, Malaysia could not match the market size, profit options, and growth of countries such as Indonesia, Vietnam, and the Philippines.
To begin my presentation, I will define stock trading and financial ratios. Stock trading is known as buying and selling activities of publicly listed company share on a stock exchange platform. It involves market participants, including investors and traders, placing money to work and potentially building wealth. A financial ratio is the significance of two numerical values taken from the company's financial statements. It has been an analytical tool since the 1920s. Moreover, many studies assume they are a great predictors of a firm's financial and business achievements and characteristics. According to Kabir et al., financial ratios refers to a widely used tools of financial analysis to clarify financial statements and have provided a quick manifestation of a firm's performance and financial position to several users of the financial statement. Stock price varies daily in stock markets. Furthermore, during certain times of the year, it is accessible to concern that stock price rise every morning, and this can happen numerous times in a single day for some stocks. This means that supply and demand forces drive stock price. There is no foolproof system for evaluating stock price movement. However, the factors driving changes in demand and supply for a specific stock could include company fundamentals, external factors, and market behavior. Moreover, qualitative factors such as a change in the board of directors and the appointment of new management should also be considered affecting the stock price. External factors might include government rules and regulation, inflation, and other economic condition, investor behavior, market condition, money supply, competition, uncontrolled natural or environmental circumstances directly affecting the production of the companies and strikes. Other key variables are gross domestic product, unemployment rate, interest rate, budget deficit, inflation, sentiment, and sector analysis. Investors and traders need to analyze stocks before buying them. Fundamental and technical analysis are two popular stock analysis techniques used by investors. Fundamental analysis is based on critically comparing a stock's intrinsic value to the current market price. In contrast, technical analysis evaluates equity securities by analyzing previous stock price and volume caused by market activity. This presentation is focused on financial ratio analysis a cornerstone of fundamental analysis. Fundamental analysis is regarded as one of the most straightforward methods to determine the fair value of the company. It is a technique used to determine the value of stock by focusing on underlying factors that affect a company's current operations and prospects. Financial ratios are widely used in fundamental analysis. They are used to determine their intrinsic value, distinguishing them from technical analysis, which does not measure a stock's intrinsic value but instead use charts and other instruments to identify patterns that can advocate for potential activity. Financial ratios are used for a variety of reasons. These include assessing a firm's ability to pay its debts, evaluating business and managerial success, and even statutory regulation of a firm's performance. It can assist investors in making investment decisions and forecasting corporate performance in the future. Numerous ratios, including but not limited, can be divided into four groups: profitability, efficiency, leverage, and liquidity. As you can see in the screen, there are several popular ratios used by investors like return on equity, return on asset, total asset turnover, current ratio, debt to equity ratio, earning per share, dividend payout ratio, and price to earning ratio. There has been much debate in the traditional literature about which ratios are most useful for assessing the likelihood of failure. Our review demonstrates that return on equity, debt ratio, and dividend payout ratio are ineffective predictors of stock price changes. Total asset turnover, current ratio, and debt to equity ratio all have an impact on the stock price. And earning per share, return on asset, and price to earning ratio are the most important financial ratios for investors and traders to consider when making their decision. These ratios become the things that would be the focus of the investors when they do the valuation regarding the financial ratio. For the conclusion, the findings are mixed, but the return on asset, earning per share, and price to earning ratio should be included in the list of investors and traders when performing the ratio analysis. It is recommended that all investors and traders determine how to weigh information to decide regarding their investment decision. That's all from us. Jazakallah khairah. Thank you.